Hello guys, I'm Mechanic Bright. Customer complains no honking sound. Even I honk the horn, nothing sounds at all. Today I'm gonna show how to check power circuit from the relay and also ground circuit. It's not very hard. So this one is a 14F150, can easy to access under the just hood, and then only electric connector and one 10mm bolt is mounted. And I replaced the horn since the 15, any model or year, 90% of problem horn assembly. Not many time circuit problem. So I'm gonna show this connector and then check. This one is a horn circuit, 15F50, slightly different voltage, but it's almost similar. Horn relay controlled by the VCM, once horn switch pressed, and then VCM energized the relay and powered through the horn assembly. Fuse is 22 old F-150 until 14 model, and then since the 15 is 43 old F1 fuse. It depends on model. So relay energized powered through the horn. So I'm gonna check this one circuit. There's a two connector. One is the power from the relay. Another one is grounded to the shash. I'm using adapter pin for the video, but you guys can use a safety pin or test lamp directly. I'm gonna check the ground circuit first. When check the ground circuit, alligator clamp to the positive, not clamp. Alligator to the positive terminal, battery terminal, and then I check the circuit and this test lamp, black gray. Now touch the black gray, now it's a green light. That means ground circuit is good. Now as you can see that green light on, that means ground circuit is fine. Next, I'll check positive and battery voltage from the relay. Clamp the alligator clip to battery negative or shash ground. So, and then test lead and to the pin 2, yellow red. We'll check power and positive from the relay. I go back to the driver's side and I honk the horn, push the handle switch, and then you guys can see red light. If the red light on test lamp, power circuit is okay. I'll go back to the drive side now. And then you guys can see that red light on, that means fuse from the relay from the through the wire to the on connector. That means relay, fuse, circuit, and a BCM control, all is fine. We verified all the circuit is good, fuse, relay, and then ground is all okay. We can change horn assembly. Until 14 model is so easy to access a horn assembly, but since the 15 model, this one, and then even 21, 22 model, it's so much tricky and last work. Workshop said remove radiator grill assembly, but I showing without grill. So you guys top cover, radiator top cover, and air deflector cover, and then remove the retainers, all of the retainer, and then take away this top cover, air deflector cover. And then I'm showing without radiator, and then replace the horn assembly. So top side four radiator grill mount bolt was located top of the radiator grill. So remove four radiator top mount bolt, even one retainer, two four side retainer clips like this. And then now a little bit tricky. Now, this radiator grill attached the headlight. So I'm gonna pull the as much as I can like this, and then insert wood block kind of 2 inch around, and then push it in between front rigid subframe, support frame, and rigid assembly, like this. You guys can see the bolt, and then right hand side kind of small narrow hole access, can access. So ratcheting wrench can access top bolt, and then can see the bottom of the connector right here. And I go through my hand and then right hand side between gap and disconnect connector right here. So I disconnect horn connector, and then ratcheting or whatever you want, and a small tiny 10 millimeter wrench, and then loose mount bolt. Once loosed all mount 10 millimeter bolt, may drop the horn assembly between radiator, but don't worry, we have a new one. So I try to take it out between hood latch and radiator, but it's stuck because radiator supporter, this one plastic attached. So I removed this bracket, doesn't affect the radiator function. So you guys can remove between latch and radiator support. Sometimes remove hood latch assembly like this, and then make a room, and then put it back to the horn assembly between radiator support and radiator. So it is much room. So I'm showing another way, and a much easier. And if you have big hands, cannot access the left hand corner room, access the connector. Yeah, it's so much hard. My hand is pretty small, but your hand is pretty much big, and so cannot access go through your big hand. So I'm showing other way. This is horn go through this way. It's much easier. When you go through this way, you need to first remove door or latch assembly. So after the latch assembly, and then can access the hands this way, and much can be easier to attach the mount bolt, even attach the electric connector, and then tighten the latch, and then much easier, so fast. You know, workshop manual says remove radiator grill first, and then access the horn connector, and even hole mount to this bolt. But that labor, even follow workshop manual, that so much take a time, and then so much expensive labor. 1.5 it take a time, but this way less than 30 minutes. You guys can change yourself and your truck horn assembly. So easy. So put the back hood latch, and it's own place. I recommend, pretty much recommend, you put a remove hood latch bolt, and then mark the paint mark sometime. Even much better to original place, put it back to the bolts. And then make sure all connection is fine, and then put the back on place radiator grill, even tighten all of the radiator grill and retainer, and then check the horn all horn function is okay. Thank you for watching.